Oh no, he tore down the wall! Oh no! Oh, he's very angry about life! Yo, 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 everybody. Generikb here. Welcome back to another episode of Unturned on the GangZ server. Hey, today we've got a couple little projects to do. Before I begin, though, I want to thank you. I wish this game had a thing where I could look back at you guys, because I love doing that, the F5 in Minecraft. I love that, so I can actually, like, it feels like I'm talking to you guys, because I really want to talk to you for a minute. I want to thank you so much, really from the bottom of my heart, for all of your support on this series. You guys are really loving it. The views have been really good. The likes have been really good. If you guys are watching this and you want to show your support, please drop a like on it. And if you want to see more and you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do so, because liking and subscribing are the two things that you can do that help me out the most. Helps get the word out about my videos and stuff like that. YouTube has been kind of wonky this year for a lot of stuff. They've changed some algorithms, and so views ain't so good on things. But this is doing really well. I'm going to keep it up. Thank you guys so much. All right. That being said, we've had some people doing a little sneaky in our base. I ain't going to name names, but there's been a couple, and they've been ransacking us, using our base like a quickie mart for all of their food and ammunition needs. They put a ladder on here, which I can't take off. I mean, I guess I could if I took a hatchet to it. You know, I could try that. Maybe this will work. Anywho, I put the sandbags up there. Now I've built one of those flags that make it to where it's like a safety flag, so where no one can build in a certain radius around our base. And so that'll prevent this from happening in the future. I'm gonna give it one last good one. Okay, two more. And no, okay. So also up here, I've made some vaults. Because I had crafting 3 from making the RV, I figured I'd go ahead and put that to good use. Bum, 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 bum. So we've got like various handguns, and I've spent a lot of time organizing, putting a lot of the bullets back together. Because that's really important, man. The guns and the ammo are important. There's our timber wolf. Yeah, that's right. That's right. So Dark Fan, I believe, made this to where he did it kind of makeshifty because of these water reserves. But so now the only thing that's exposed are these actual water barrels. They can't get in anywhere else. Hopefully. Alright. I just got wrecked by one of those. Oh, that's not how I wanted to do. Give it to me. There we go. That's a garage frame. Pecker. Metal post, maybe. Metal post. Metal wall. Okay, I've got a bunch of this stuff. I'm gonna grab a bunch of scrap metal. Oh, I've been working on the scrap metal. So, they call me the tin can man, because I have been just scrapping like there's no tomorrow. But, the megazombie wrecked me. I tried a thing which worked once, and I don't know if Nelson tweaked it to where it doesn't work anymore, or I just kind of screwed up. But there's a trick on the military base. You saw Dahl; he jumped on the fence, and that's cool. There's another option. Let's do a little sneaky sneak down there and see if we can do what we do. So he's right there. He chased me down and murdered me. But you're supposed to be able to jump on top of those fuel tanks, and they won't be able to hit you. And I've done it once before, but it kind of stopped working. So I decided to let's give it another option. Let's give it another try. That is not what I want to use. Get this thing out of my life. You know, it's kind of dark. It's a little too dark to see. All right, let me clear this out and wait till daytime. And then we will be right back. Okay, so we're back. Good thing too, because I needed to just kind of like play around. This is actually my first time building stuff in the game, like building like house type building things. So you got to put these pillars down. I like a soul. Hey, I got an achievement unlocked. I'm fortified. And so then I've built a roof. I made this window. And I think this is, I'll put it here. And then I made this bar fortification because I thought it would be so cool. If I just put that in and, boy, ain't that bizarre. That does not do what I thought it would do at all. Very strange. Okay. And then we got a doorway. I built a wall. Kaplunk. And I'm thinking maybe I put another wall there. I don't know how smart these bad boys are. Now here's my goal and my guess, and we're gonna figure this out together. I don't think that the big boy can make it through that guy. But in the event that he can, like, if I just do something like a metal pipe, okay, I can get through that. I feel pretty sure the other dude can't. Now, if I were to make this even cooler, I'm sure there's gonna be a better way to do this, but, okay, so I can get in. I feel pretty sure that dude can't get in. I don't know if he's going to be attacking barricades. It's things we shall find. Okay, so he's way over there, so we're going to have to do a little clear job because we don't want everybody and their dang brother coming over. Place your bets, people. Is this going to work, or am I going to die a horrible, horrible death? I got a good feeling about it. So, do a little business and... Okay, he's not coming over. Okay. And he's coming. Okay. Okay, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming, he's coming. Oh, yeah, this is gonna be nice. Okay, come on, pal. Come on, pal. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Yeah, boy. Yeah, you know, boy. Hey, all right, so this would be perfect. Now we pretend. We go, all right, because that's about where he spawns. I hit him. He's super mad. He comes in. Honk. And? Come on. There I am. Okay, and? Oh, he's trying to get it. Don't get it. Don't get it. Don't make it happen. Don't break that. Don't do it. Don't break it. Don't do that. Hey, stop. Stop what you're doing. Stop it. You need to stop it. You need to stop hitting that. Stop hitting yourself. Stop hitting yourself. Okay, now it's a race. Will he break it before I break him? Oh no, he tore down the wall! Oh no! Oh, he's very angry about life! Please die, you fool. Please don't come in and kill me. Please don't come in and kill me. Don't, please don't come in and kill me. Please don't come in and kill me. Please don't come in and kill me. Oh please. Oh please, 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 please. Oh, good Lord, thank you. Okay, so look at me. I'm using this. What do we get? Holy crap, military drum, tactical light, cross scope, horizontal clip, frag grenade. He didn't really give us that much. And he took out our front wall. What a jerk. But that's okay. I think I can handle that because, like, to make the front wall, it's really only maybe 20 metal. And I can get that super quick just by mining those guys around here. So all in all, not a bad maneuver. I could have given him the strong stuff right there, and that probably would have made it even quicker. If we play our cards right, yeah, we may be able to do that without taking the damage. Okay, sweet. I chalked that up as a success, if I do say so myself. All right, so on to the next little experimentation. Dude, it is nighttime. I just found some of these civilian night vision goggles, and it makes everything look super creepy. It's like I'm in an old Alfred Hitchcock movie. Oh, civilian vest. Thank you. It's so cool. I'm just trying to get some more material. And it's raining, by the way, which makes it even more creepy. Woo! All right, I think I've got just about all I need. So I'm going to head on back and prepare for my next little project, my next idea. I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. Boom, 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 on the road again. Just can't wait. Whoa. Just need to stay on the road again. Do, 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 do. All right, so it is the next day, and I got all the stuff together that I need. Hey, cowboy. Hey, zoomp. We are going to start the very first business in the spirit of the B team. We always have to make sure that we try to flim-flam people and make some money. I mean, that's why I went to prison. B-Dubs escaped. He's a lot slicker. He's faster than I am because he's younger, you see? But, oh, gotta stay in the road now. Oh, hey, Lord, hey, stay. but the spirit lives on. I've figured out, honestly, a really, really cool idea. Now, it will require, ooh, those moth berries. I'll get them on the way back. It will require a bit of some honor system, obviously, but I think all in all, this is really going to be something good, because the purpose of a business, right? Let's see, where I gotta park this somewhere. This is where we're gonna be. Let's park it in those trees, maybe, because I'm gonna be here a while. I want to make sure, you know, that the business is good. Oh yeah, right in here. Right in this little area is perfect. Yes, right like that. Okay, get out. Okay, so I got all my stuff I need in storage right here. First things first, though, we have to set up camp. So we're just gonna... Cause like I said, I'm gonna be here for a hot minute, so let's get a little campfire going. Just put it right there. Get a little bedroll going. Equip and ride like champ. I don't like it there. Maybe a little something just like that. Perfect. So I'm nice and sleepy by the fire. When the nighttime comes, I love it. Someone suggested that I have a place to store gas cans. Oh, as I open this up, ta-da! Look at that. And it really looks cool. It looks like it's right in there. So I can look at it, and I think both of these are... Oh, that one's actually full. Nice. That one's empty, so I'll take an empty one later. We'll fill it up. But... I'm gonna grab all the stuff I need. I've got a couple rain barrels. I've got a green umbrella and a green couch because we're the Stanky Leg Boys, green team. Some ladders, got a cooler, couple signs, and a birch library, which is what is the whole crux of the thing. This is the key, because, yes, there's money in the game, but money is kind of worthless. This is the post-apocalypse, you know what I'm saying? Okay, ooh, there is. Let's... We're not the only chaps on the server right now. Cube is here. Cube might be going around doing stuff, but it looks like we're safe. Okay, yeah, I think we're safe. So, people have been robbing and stealing from other people's bases to try to get, to get food and water and stuff. And that is because food and water is at a premium. This is the apocalypse, post-apocalypse, right? So there is always that issue where you can't get, you can't get food and water. That's like sometimes more important than a gun is having food and water. That's what survival's all about. So what I thought I would do is set up a little store, and it's going to be Uncle Jenny's 100% organic free range snack shack. Where would be a good place for it? I'm thinking kind of right by the road. So let's dispense of these foolios. And alright. So first things first, let's grab ourselves a ladder. Okay, and this is what I want to know. If I put a ladder like that, right? Oh, that's how that works. Oh, perfect. That's okay. I just want to make sure it's easy for people to get up and easy for them to get down. Perfect. Works. Okay. Now, I'll set up a nice little spot for them to chill. Nope, that's wrong. Packer. Oh, no, that's not where I wanted, but we'll stick a little guy right there. Grab ourselves an umbrella. A little shade as you do. Because you want to make sure that people are, comfortable. And then we'll put a couple rain barrels. And I'll just stick them like kind of right here, I think. Another one. Yeah. We have a cooler. Dude, I don't know if you can see this, but Beans is going between between Unturned and Ark. It's like, make up your mind, dude. What game you gonna play today? Okay, so we got that. We've got that. Anything else? We're gonna have a sign. But then this library, this is the key, the whole key to things. And we're gonna put the library, maybe we put it like right here. Kablunk, that works, I like it. Okay, and then we're gonna grab a sign and put the sign, y'all won't get me this time. It goes like this. And boom. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have this library. For those of you who don't know what this is like XP storage. So you hit use, right? And it has a capacity of 800. So it can store up to 800 skill points, right? And I have 23 available, and I got to deposit. Now, it will take a 10% tax off of it. So, for example, if I say I want to deposit 10, one will disappear. That's the price of admission. And then it will store 9 in there. So what I'm going to do, I think I'm going to make it 5 per, but people will have to put in their own amount, right? Oop. F. And that is going to be the payment. And so all the items, which I've got some stuff. I don't want to give the coke. I have I have stuff for the other Coke, or other plans for that Coke. But all this, like, you know, juices and chocolate bars and stuff like that, I can put in here. And I got a bunch over in the RV to do that as well. Oh, here's one right there. Uh-huh. So as you're traveling around, let's say you're a little hungry, maybe you don't have all of the, you know, all of the nutritious stuff in order to top yourself off. Like me, look at me, I'm down to 38, 37. I'm like, oh crap, how's my canteen? Well, I have some, but now I don't. Now I'm screwed, right? Well, if there was some water right there, hey, no problem. I would spend my 5 skill points. Everybody's got 5 skill points. Pay my 5 skill points, grab myself some water, and I'm on my way. Right? It ain't bad. It's a pretty cool little system. Okay, so what I'm going to do is let me go look up how to make fancy signs, and I will be right back. Well, I got it all set up, but the full moon's here, and I'm stuck. So, and I'm also kind of hungry, so I guess I gotta pay. No, I don't gotta pay. I own this place, but I'm gonna take this bad boy. Let's equip it. Just give me a little bit. Ah, ooh, that felt good. So here's what I got. All food and drink. Oh God, that scared me. All food and drink items, 5 skill points per item. Deposited in bookcase. Shoplifters will be shot twice. And the way you do the special stuff is, like, you can do bold, you can do color equals, and I just grabbed that off the internet, showing, like, what kind of colors and stuff you can do. So got that, and life is pretty good. And then down here, let's see, if they try to come up after me, I can always just kind of run back up. But I think I'm safe. Uncle Jenny's 100% organic and free-range snack shack. Tasty food, clean water, cheap prices, just up this ladder. And see, it's got a glow to it. People are going to see that from quite a ways. They're going to be like, whoa, what is that? We're going to be making some serious, serious do-re-mi on that. You know, I'm kind of curious. Let's see something here. They say that this is their double XP now. Yeah, like, see, here comes this guy. Come on, pal. You want to know about me? And, hey. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, it's plus 6 XP. That's not terrible. Ooh, I may run around here and clean this up, make some points, because I need to, because I died a couple times last night. All right, fellas, that's going to do it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please be sure and leave a like, and if you really love it and you want to see more, be sure and subscribe. Thank you guys so much for your love and support. I love you guys so much. Until next time, take care. Brush your hair. I'll see you when I see you. Peace. Right.